So I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation. And in this presentation, I will talk about the study of phase dynamics in unconventional Joyce-Sohn junctions, in particular ferromagnetic Joyce-Sohn junctions. And this work has been done in Napoli at Università Federico II, and in collaboration with the material science group of University of Cambridge. So, in the last few years, there has been a remarkable progress in the development of hybrid Joyce-Sohn junctions with barriers composed by semiconducting nanowires, graphene sheets, topological insulators, ferromagnetic materials, and so on. And the idea of these devices is to combine the properties of different materials. For instance, with these structures, we have the opportunity to combine superconductivity with ferromagnetism, spin orbit coupling, gate tunable electric field effects. And on one end, the goal is to realize and develop devices with new or better functionalities. And this is valid also in the field of superconducting qubits. Here there are a few examples of hybrid Joyce-Sohn junctions employed in quantum circuits. And one of the goals in this case is based on the capability to tune the relevant scaling energy of Joyce-Sohn junctions, the critical current, so the Joyce-Sohn energy, in order to reduce a specific noise source. For instance, in this case, in the gate one qubit, a gate voltage is used in order to tune the Joyce-Sohn energy. On one end, spin triple Cooper pairs, Majorana fermions, topological superconductivity, for instance, find in the Joyce-Sohn coupling the way to be studied, detected, and manipulated. Therefore, within this context, it is quite important to distinguish between the different dissipation sources, whose origin may depend on the type of the barrier, on the nature of the interface, on the geometry of the junction, and so on. And standard current voltage characteristics are the first imprint of Joyce-Sohn junctions, but in general do not provide all the information we need. A powerful tool in order to study dissipation in a junction is given by the measurements of critical current fluctuations, the switching current distributions, and the temperature behavior of the width sigma. So the phase dynamics of a current bias Joyce-Sohn junction has been introduced by Francesco on Tuesday. Now I would like only to stress again that the resistivity and capacitive shunt junction model tells us that a Joyce-Sohn junction can be modeled by an ideal Joyce-Sohn element in parallel with a resistance associated to the junction and a capacitance which comes from the electric nature of the barrier. If we take into account the two Joyce-Sohn equations and the equation for the equivalent circuit, we obtain a differential equation for the phase particle, which is analog to the motion. We obtain a differential equation for the phase, which is analog to the motion of a particle in the tilted washboard potential. The damping of this motion is given by the quasi factor Q, which is the plasma frequency times the RC product. So when we increase the bias current, we increase the tilt of the washboard potential, and at the same time we reduce the height of the potential barrier. Then thermal fluctuations may induce the escape of the phase particle or quantum tunneling across the potential barrier. After the escape event, we have the transition to the running state, to the finite voltage state, if the damping is quite low, so if the junction is in the underdamped regime with a quasi factor much more larger than one. Therefore, the transition, the switching from the superconducting state to the resistive state is a stochastic phenomenon, and the measurements of switching current distributions provide the tool to investigate the phase dynamics. Recently, the new technologies applied to more and more to superconducting junctions have led to a reduction of the dimensions of the junctions, and therefore a reduction of the critical current values. This means that the Jeffson junctions fall in the modulated damping regime with a quality factor of the order of one. In this case, the phase dynamics is a little bit different, since after the escape event, the phase particle may be retrapped in one of the following minima. And this process of escape and retrapping may occur multiple times, generating a diffusive motion of the phase particle. And this, this regime is known as phase diffusion regime. The fingerprint of this regime is given by this streaking collapse of sigma above the transition temperature. In the last 10 years, the moderated damping regime has been observed in many different types of Jeffson junctions, and all the results can be described in terms of phase diagram, therefore in terms of fundamental quantities, such as the Jeffson energy, the thermal energy, the junction quality factor Q. Of course, all these methods can be used to study the phase dynamics of hybrid Jeffson junctions. And in the last few years, we have studied the phase dynamics of different types of hybrid systems, in particular ferromagnetic junctions with barrier composed by poor metallic layers, or junctions with a barrier composed by an insulating layer and a ferromagnetic layer, the SIFS junctions, or junctions with a ferromagnetic insulator barrier. And these two cases are more relevant for the study of macroscopic quantum phenomena and will be discussed in the second part of this talk. So spin-filled Jeffson junctions have been realized in Cambridge and are the first, and up to now the solely Jeffson junctions with a ferromagnetic insulator barrier, which is gadolinium nitride. Due to the exchange field in the barrier, spin up and spin down electrons see different barrier gate, and this results in a spin polarization. We have measured these junctions for different values of the barrier thickness, therefore for in a wide range of critical current values. And these junctions present unconventional features. Some of them, such as this unconventional 0-2-pi transition, will be discussed by Roberta Caruso in tomorrow morning, the second session. Another unconventional feature is based on the magnetic field pattern, in particular on the periodicity of the magnetic field pattern. Indeed, for spin-filter junctions, the period of the pattern is half of the expected value, and is half of the value measured on the corresponding non-spin-filter junctions for the same geometry. And this feature has been studied in detail by the Cambridge group in this paper. And coming to the conclusion that the current phase relation in these junctions should be dominated by a second harmonic component. So usually, ferromagnetic Jeffson junctions are composed by metallic layers, and therefore the IV curves found in literature are non-hysteretic with the low values of the CRM product of the order of few microvolt, and the junctions fall in the overdamped regime. On the other hand, due to the insulating nature of the barrier, the current voltage characteristics are hysteretic, with hysteresis larger than 90%. The ICRM product is quite high, of the order of few millivolt, and the junctions fall in the underdamped regime. This has been observed also by measuring the switching current distributions. Indeed, at high temperatures, the width of switching current distributions increases when increasing the temperature, which is in the thermal activation regime, which is the typical behavior of underdamped junctions. Moreover, below a crossover temperature about 100 millikelvin, both the mean switching current and the width switching current distributions saturate, indicating the transition to the quantum regime. In order to be sure that this saturation is not due to spurious noise or heating in the measurement setup, we have measured the switching current distributions in presence of magnetic field. And we have found lower values of sigma and a lower value of the crossover temperature in agreement with the MQT theory. Therefore, these results represent the first evidence of macroscopic quantum phenomena in ferromagnetic junctions, in particular in spin filter junctions, which are characterized by all these properties, and therefore pave the way for the possible use of these systems also in quantum circuits as active elements. Then, since a second harmonic component is expected in the current phase relation, the Washburn potential becomes a double well potential. And depending on the junction parameters, for a double well potential, two critical currents could be observed. This means that when measuring the switching histograms, we may observe single mode or also bimodal switching current distributions. Therefore, we have performed numerical simulations of the phase dynamics as a function of the temperature, the quality factor, and of the G factor, which is given by the ratio between IC2 and IC1 in the current phase relation. And the crucial process, the retrapping process, is crucial in order to distinguish for which junction parameters and for which conditions for a double well potential, two critical currents are observed. And so, for which junction parameters, a single mode or a bimodal switching current distributions are expected. For instance, if we increase the G factor, the eight of the two wells, A and B, are comparable, approach each other, and therefore the phase particle may be retrapped in both wells with finite probability, thus resulting in the bimodal switching current distributions when counting many escape events. The results of the numerical simulations are reported in this phase diagram. And since the measurements of switching current distributions on spin filter junctions are single mode distributions in the whole temperature range, this means that we are in this part of the phase diagram. The other chance that we cannot exclude is that the current phase relation is a pure second harmonic, and therefore, in this case, the Washburn potential becomes again a single well potential. Finally, the possibility to employ these junctions in classical and quantum circuits is based also on the capability to tune the Joyce-Sonn energy, the critical current in these junctions. So, within a collaboration between the Hypress company and the group of Valery Riazanov in Moscow, magnetic junctions with a barrier composed by an insulating aluminum oxide and a ferromagnetic palladium iron barrier have been realized. And in this work, they prove the functioning principle of a cryogenic memory by using the hysteretic magnetic field pattern. This means that we may use the fact that for the same value of the magnetic field, we have two different values of the critical current. Indeed, by using magnetic field pulse of different signs, we can move along the magnetic field pattern and measure different current voltage characteristics with different values of the critical current. By using an intermediate value of the reading current. In one case, we are in the finite voltage state because the reading current is higher than the critical current. In the other state, we are in the zero voltage state because the reading current is lower than the critical current. And therefore, we may define two states, zero and one, based on the two voltage states. In collaboration with these groups, we have studied the effect of microwaves on these junctions by using microwaves within the magnetic field pulse. And the results of these experiments tell us that if we use microwaves, the separation between the critical current levels can be enhanced in a wide range of magnetic field pulse amplitude. This means that we may use a lower value of the magnetic field pulse amplitude to induce the magnetic switching, and also that we may use a lower value of the, a lower value of the reading current in order to read the state of the memory. Therefore, this means that we may improve the efficiency of this scheduling memory, but from the fundamental point of view, the important result is that we are able to manipulate the critical currents of the Joule energy of these magnetic Joule junctions. So, in conclusion, we have studied the phase dynamics of ferromagnetic Joule junctions with the ferromagnetic insulator barrier. And these junctions seem to be quite promising for possible application in classical and quantum circuits because they are characterized by high values of the SRM product, underdamped behavior, the macroscopic quantum tunneling has been demonstrated for the first time. And then we have also demonstrated that it is possible to manipulate the Joule energy by means of different tools. In this case, magnetic field pulses and microwaves. And therefore, these junctions may be used in quantum circuits in order to reduce specific noise source. And finally, I would like to thank you for the attention.